RobinReaction.com.
In this video, I'm going to go over solubility rules and practice problems. And this is going to be an intro video for people that are just learning the solubility rules. So let's just go over the definitions of soluble and insoluble. So for all of these things, what we're talking about is dumping usually some type of powder or crystal in water and then stirring it around and saying, does it dissolve? So for things that are soluble, that means it does dissolve. So if we have a little pile of salt or sugar and we put it in our water and then we go ahead and stir, it's all going to dissolve. And then when we look at the water, it's just going to look clear. There's not going to be any particles in it. And for insoluble things, again, if we start and we have our little pile, and then we go ahead and stir, no matter how much you stir, it's never going to dissolve. All that's going to happen is that the particles are going to spread out. So an example like this is like if you put flour into water. If you put flour in water, it's never going to dissolve. You can stir it around, but all you're going to do is mix up the flour to be in the water. So you're still going to see visible particles, and they will not be dissolved. All right, so that's the definition. That's what you have to understand before you do these practice problems. Now let's look at this big grid we have. So your textbook or your teacher probably has some grid that's very similar to this that just breaks down what's soluble and what's not soluble. And so let's go ahead and do our practice problems, determine if the following compounds are soluble or insoluble, and figure out how we use this graph or grid. And also, if you're in AP chemistry, you're definitely going to have to memorize this grid, and it's one of the most important things you can memorize. So just get it out of the way and memorize it now. It sucks. I get it. I'm glad I don't have to memorize them. But if you're in AP Chem, you have to. If you're in a different chemistry class, it's just going to depend on your teacher and what their role is. All right, so let's start with lead sulfide over here on the left-hand side. And so what we have to do is kind of hunt around in our grid and look and see what we can find. And so you always want to look for something that's on this left-hand side first. So you always want to start with just finding a key ingredient and saying, is it soluble or is it not soluble? And you could find the cation, the positively charged ion, or the anion, the negatively charged ion, in the grid. It doesn't matter. But first, what I really see is this. I see S2-. And I know that this sulfur, that's the same thing. It's just S2-. And so then I look, and it says that that sulfur is insoluble. And so this little S here just means solid. It means, like in our example over here, that everything would just still be a solid. And so you check, and so we're going to say, okay, our compound is pretty much, is probably going to be insoluble because sulfur is insoluble, but let's go ahead and check the exceptions before we make that determination. So we see that molecules with NH4+, lithium, sodium, potassium, calcium, strontium, and barium are exceptions, which would mean that they're soluble. But we're using lead, and so that's not in our exceptions. So we can go ahead and say that lead sulfide is insoluble. All right, so that's it for these practice problems, and let's just do a few more examples. So over here, we have lithium and sulfate. So let's just go ahead and scan. And right away, I actually see two different things. I see sulfate, that is in the soluble category. And so this AQ just means aqueous, which means it's dissolved in water. And so for the exceptions, calcium, strontium, barium, lead. So lithium is not one of the exceptions. And also I can see that lithium is up here and that it's soluble. So this is super soluble. So now sodium carbonate. And so once again, I'm going to go ahead. I see sodium right here. And I look and I see that there are no exceptions. So that means no matter what is with sodium, it's going to be soluble. So that means that this compound is completely soluble. And also, just to double up on that, I could have also went ahead and saw, okay, I have my carbonate here, which is insoluble, but an exception is sodium. So either way, I would have gotten to the fact that this molecule is soluble. So now next, I have silver bromide. So I don't see silver anywhere on the left-hand side, but I do see bromide. And so it's looking like it's going to be soluble, but uh-oh, I have my first exception. So when it's with silver, that's an exception and it's insoluble. So that means that even though bromide wanted to be soluble, the silver was an exception, so it's insoluble. All right, so next I have calcium iodide. And looking up here on my left-hand side, I don't see calcium, but I do see iodide right here. And so it's looking like it's going to be soluble. Let's just check the exceptions. That's silver, mercury, and lead. So none of the exceptions apply to calcium, which means it's going to go ahead and still be soluble. And then last but not least, we have silver nitrate. So looking for either one, I don't see any silver, I don't see Ag, but I do see NO3 right here. And then I see, okay, it has no exceptions. Every single thing that has nitrate is soluble. All right, so that's all you have to do for these problems. It's just a matter of memorizing the rules. Don't think too much about, well, why is this soluble and this is insoluble? It doesn't really matter. There's no real way at this point in your chemistry education that you'd be able to predict these without memorizing them or any rules that you've learned that would make these things make sense without memorization. This is just a pure memorization. You gotta have this grid either in your mind or on the page before you can do these practice problems. All right, happy studying.
Hey, I hope you liked that video. Please feel free to like, comment, or subscribe. And if you go to my website, I have a ton of free practice problems you can check out. And if you need even more help, you can hire me for one-on-one private tutoring sessions that are online. All right, thanks, that's it. Happy studying.